PMOtto beta version is out there, and I want to share with you some of the features and some of the ideas behind of what we aim to be, the most powerful source of project management information using generative AI. Let's see. I created PMOtto with some friends in 2017. And the aim was to use the power at that time of machine learning to help project managers to deliver better projects. With all the growth of generative AI, we included all aspects of generative AI with the knowledge around project management to create a unique product that will be the virtual assistant for all things project management. But before I go into the demo, I want just to draw and explain a little bit of the rationale. First, PMOtto is based on a large language model, and we are using today the GPT-4 provided by OpenAI as, I would say, our core of natural language. So when I think about that, I think that this center or this nucleus of PMOtto is the GPT-4. And you may ask me, so why should I need to use PMOtto and not GPT-4 or not BARD or not, for example, any other large language model? It's because we built on the top of this first layer a second layer. And this second layer is the project management layer. On this beta version, we are using all knowledge provided by Antonio Nieto Rodriguez, one of the leading names in project management, the author of the Harvard Business Review Project Management Handbook. So we are using his information, articles, insights, presentations, videos, and also all my content from podcasts, from articles, from books, everything, and we combine it. But when you do this search and you use a PMOtto, you are not searching for a document like you do on Google, for example, or on my personal website. No. What we did, we used these documents to train the large language model. So to make sure that these two areas, they meld themselves into one piece. So it's like the ChatGPT with the turbocharge of project management knowledge. So someone that will have some specific knowledge around project management and around this very specific topic on how do we manage projects and all the interconnections of managing projects. And this second layer will be updated on a daily basis. Every new thing, every new agreement that we make, we will bring into this database. So this database, we aim to be a massive learning database. Of course, ChatGPT will bring all the natural language on the top of all this specific. So we want to collaborate with associations. We want to collaborate with authors. We want to collaborate with anyone producing interesting and relevant content on project management to build this second layer. And this is why we are still on beta, because we are today we probably have around 2,500 different documents, including podcast transcripts, videos, and everything. But our aim is to build pretty much everything that is available for us to use in this tool. And this brings us our second layer. This second layer in the future will be accessed by subscription. So normal people, anyone, junior, senior project managers, they can just subscribe and they will have 24x7 a machine learning in natural language that will help them with any question, any content, anything they may need at their fingerprints. But there is a third layer. And this third layer is what will bring a uniqueness of PMOtto to the corporate world. And this third layer will add company-specific information. And this third layer means you are a company. And on this third layer, this blue layer, you will be able to put the PMO methodology, reports, information of projects. You can extract information from your internal systems. And these people with access to this third layer will be able to combine the third with the second and the first. So you can, for example, go on PMOtto and say, what should I concern today in my portfolio of projects? Then what will happen? This information will come here and will say, what people should matter? This is the project management content. We'll translate this into natural language and we'll check here in your database, checking which projects have that issue or not, do not have that issue to present to you. So it's the end of your need of reporting. It's the end. You just say, what should I be concerned this week with this project? And what is the most important? We are building this using all the security that is required among these layers. So if you are a company, you can define who will have access. Even us, we do not have access to this blue area. It's you. You will have the part that you can upload your documents and these will stay in your own server. What we will do, we will combine and melt this into the machine learning. And you will ask this in a seamless, you will navigate on layer 3, layer 2, and layer 1 in the natural language. This is our aim. Today, we are releasing this layer 2, and this is exactly what I want to show you now with PMOtto. So when you see here, this is the basic screen. Remember, we are improving this as we speak, okay? So what we did, just to make the use very simple, we create a very clean interface. And here, in this area, is where you type your message. There is a button here where you can create a new chat. You can select GPT 3.5 or GPT 4. And I want just to stop here. Today, we are using the Microsoft platform. PMOtto is part of the Microsoft Startup Program, so they are giving us all support. But the concept that we aim on PMOtto is that it doesn't matter how these evolve, we'll be always able to connect with a large language model. And today we are using GPT-4. If in the future is a different one, we will be able to connect pretty much the same way. And the user will not even know. So probably in the future, you will not select anymore GPT 3.5 or 4. But we are doing this because GPT 3.5 is very fast. And for simple tasks, it's quite good. And GPT 4 is more complex and more elaborated. As we speak, these things will change. And this is mostly for the beta versions because we have limits. So the beta users will have a limit of tokens that they can use over time. And this is just to know if you are exceeding that limit or not. So just to give you an idea, one question and one answer, it's roughly 1,500 tokens. And if you want to have more information, you know, you can just click on the information here and you can see how the tokens, okay, for you to understand a little bit better. These tokens can be a letter, can be a phrase, and this is the way a GPT-4 measure performance and measure usage of the tool. And here is my login, and this is the chat history that I will show you in a minute. So let me use it a little bit. For example, I'm building a house. Let me do a very simple example. I'm building a house. So what I want PMOtto to answer to me. I want PMOtto to suggest the first level of a work breakdown structure of my new house that I'm building for my family, okay? And I want them to split the work in types of work required in the house. So I will just send this to PMOtto. And here it is. So it's explained to me. It's suggesting me these 7 items. And remember, this is a high-level WBS, each of these tasks, okay, it's explaining a little bit. That is the concept behind all these large language models. And I can do it in a different way. I can say, I created the WBS. And the WBS has these foundation, walls, ceiling, plumbing, electrical works, carpentry, painting, and finishing. I just want to know, please, PMOtto, am I missing something? There is something I need to be concerned of. And then I just send this. So it's answering me, okay, you have this, but it's suggesting me heating and ventilation, okay, permits and Leo, it's suggesting me other things. If I don't like, I have the thumbs down button, I have the thumbs up, and I can copy this to wherever I want. Just continue on the same thread. I can also make another request. I want, for example, a list of risks of this project. So I want to ask PMOtto, I'm building a new home, prepare a list of detailed risks of this project based on the different types of work and use the following structure. What the risk is, what's the trigger for the risk to happen, what is the impacted area if the risk happens. Present it in a unique sentence for each risk. Okay, then I send. Here you can see, look, all the risks here, the 8 risks it suggested me. And of course, I can come here and create a new chat. And it cleaned for me my screen and I can work on, for example, a different topic. Now I want to analyze my stakeholders. And then I want to say, okay, I'm building the new house. I need the main stakeholder. I want also that you put the level of interest in the project of each stakeholder. And I want to do it in a low, medium, high, power and influence, suggest a communication approach. So I want to prepare a stakeholder and a communication plan at the same time. And I want this in a table format, okay, to help me with that. And then I just press send. And here we are. You can see the table, everything, local government, suppliers, okay, and it gives me some hits. So look, I can save hours and hours of work using this. And this is being updated as we speak with different stakeholder matrix templates and everything. More generic templates on this layer. And if you are using the corporate, your templates on this. And what is important? That is a completely blockage from, for example, anyone using this level to use this. This is your corporate. This will be accessed with your login information inside your company. And you can define all the policies on how people can access this information and what type of information based on the Active Directory and all the protections of your network. This here will be access to all subscribers, so all this database. And here in the middle, we have the GPT-4 that will be the engine of this natural language. Because for me, the key aspect of PMOtto and what makes PMOtto easier, saving you time on learning, saving you time, for example, when you update anything on your project, and saving time on reporting because you just use natural language. And if you come here on the chat history, you can have your chat history. You can, for example, put on a favorite and then you will access the favorite chats because you can have, for example, a favorite chat that you are preparing for a certification or a chat about a report or a chat about one specific project. So you can, and remember, as a large language model, it learns as we speak. So if you use more and give more context, it will improve the answers. And of course, we can see here 97,300 tokens. So it will update all the time. What I'm showing you is the beta version. This is a beta and we are aiming to test. But what you will see very soon, that on the top of this, it will recommend to you the videos. It will recommend to you the documents. It will recommend the books you should use, or even if you are on this third, the methodology, or for example, something in your internal file system that will explain how to do that, or a specific procedure. For example, one thing that for me, it's like magic. Let's suppose you need to prepare a report. And you know, you always think, okay, what is the template for this? What is the template for that? And if you use PMOtto on this third layer, you can say, I want to use our corporate template. And it will be presented inside the corporate template with the fields of the corporate template. And these will be not only a time saver, but will help you to padronize information. It will help you to make sure that people get the information as fast as they can. They just need to ask that. So I hope you enjoyed this video, okay? For the beta tester, it's super important that you have two things in mind. Is that you should not today use confidential information or rely 100% on this, because this is a machine learning. It can have hallucinations. We are working on that diligently, but you need just to be mindful. One thing that I want just to wrap up this video, it's I always suggest anyone using artificial intelligence engines and generative AI to always keep in mind this. Look here. This is a line that goes from zero information to 100% information. You need to understand that from zero to, I would say, 5%, it's you. You. It means you need to make a right prompt. This is exactly what we write on this message area here. This is exactly what we write here. If you write in a poor way, all the engine will be in trouble. So you need to give the context. You need to be specific. You need to show your intent, and you need to present the format. This is why I call all this CSIF. Context, specific or specification, intent and format. You always need to prepare a prompt this way. This is your 5%. Then the engine brings you from 5 up to, I would say, 80%. Then comes back to you again to verify. I cannot take this and copy this table of stakeholders that I'm seeing here and just paste and put this in my report, because maybe in the middle here there's something I need to adjust. And this is exactly why we do this 20%. What we are doing now, and we are working 24x7 to improve, is to improve these red to help you to provide a little bit less and brings you closer to the endpoint. But please, every time you use this, understand this. So when you use this in a production, you need to rely on yourself to this last mile of information. And this is not PMOtto, this is every single generative AI tool you may use. And the second request is, please give us feedback if something is not right. Just be patient and provide us feedback. Tell this is not working and send to us saying, look, I didn't like this and this, because we will receive and we will compile this so we can understand what is working, what is not working, to fine-tune the engine, because our main work is to fine-tune these connections here. So I hope you enjoy using PMOtto, and please provide feedback and let's build together the future of project management. Thank you.